Alright, you're still watching Aben today, right here on Aben Television. For those of you who have updated your WhatsApp, well done. You have run away from, of course, that kind of infringement, of course, on your privacy. But getting back onto our tea at 7, we're going to be looking at sexual harassment at work. This is something that has been trailing this country, especially in government-oriented organizations. We have had these tendencies, people coming up to accuse their bosses of sexual harassment. But if we could, just bring it back to our very own point of view down here in studio, a conversation among us, the three of us, and you can also be part of this conversation by getting over to our Facebook page, which is Aben Television, and for Twitter, it is at Aben TV Uganda. Use the hashtag Aben Today. You can tag me at Anidasha Tinafius1 as well as Willis Daily. Sexual harassment. Not the very first time we're hearing of it in this country, especially in government-oriented organizations, but on the other hand, this is something that has failed to reduce. You know, complaints keep on coming. Everyone is always talking about it. What could be some of the things that, you know, give an arise to sexual harassment at workplaces?
For starters, we need to ask ourselves a very critical question.
What is
sexual harassment?
What is sexual harassment? What is deemed as sexual harassment? What should look like sexual harassment?
If I could just take a second and just Google that to get the English version of what sexual harassment is, I think it would give us a good starting point.
You don't need to Google that.
Because everyone
the meaning of sexual harassment, according to a dictionary, can even have me in prison after the show.
Thank you.
Just for touching Tina.
Thank you.
They say I sexually harassed her. Yeah. I think we need to define what sexual harassment is. Of course, harassing in the meaning of harassing itself, that one is it's pretty explainable.
Yeah.
But sexual harassment is a different thing. It's hard to define and say, someone was sexually harassed because
according to the English person or the dictionary itself, they say that sexual harassment is a behavior characterized by the making of unwelcome and inappropriate sexual remarks or physical advances in workplaces or rather professional or social
situations. What is inappropriate?
Inappropriate is maybe touching Tina's breasts. That's inappropriate.
Did you know that if I touched her hands for more than 10 times in probably a week, I would probably start sexually harassing her?
Thank you.
Really? What if it's a handshake?
Well, it would be inappropriate.
Keep shaking those hands for
me. Did you know that? Do you remember that idea that when you touch a woman's hands and scratching them,
it's
sexual?
You understand? So, define sexual harassment. I think that people in workplaces need to define sexual harassment. I've had friends who have been taken into HR offices, and an intern is saying this guy is sexually harassing me, but it turns out that the guy is just having mature conversation with someone who is above 18.
I like where you're going with that. I've had a chance to sit with different HRs, and that was the conversation, because your HR is going to tell you, HR is going to tell you if you feel like this and this and this type of way, come to me, because that's under sexual harassment. But then when you sit down and ask them, so what is deemed sexual harassment? Because I could be, me and you, our relationship and our chemistry is different from the relationship and chemistry we have, but it doesn't necessarily mean we've crossed a boundary, because according to us, we're still within our bounds. So what do we deem out of our bounds? And then moving on from there, what should be considered as sexual harassment or just two people relating?
Some people think that sexual talk is actually sexual harassment. That when I sit down with you and joking and talking about sexually related issues, that I'm sexually harassing you because you don't like it. And that's
wrong. But if the person is not interested in
You move away, you walk away. If you give me audience and then say I'm imagining you.
Willis, you have found me on my workstation. I'm on my computer. I'm, working.
Just lay away. Say, you know what? I'm not interested in that.
I don't want to have
And I will walk away. If I don't walk away, then it escalates
to sexual harassment.
Doesn't even escalate to sexual harassment. It probably escalates to... it's disturbance. It's not sexual harassment. I think sexual harassment should be when someone probably inappropriately touches you in the corridors, you understand? They are pushing you against the wall. They are being aggressive towards you. I think that becomes sexual harassment.
I believe different women will give you different... Because what you're saying is it's so physical, push you against the wall, touch you inappropriately, or say something inappropriately. Different women will come out and tell you, nah, There's more to that. Mm. It doesn't have to be that physical. It's the way he talks. It's how insinuating he is. Mm-hmm. And then we have this thing as women. If a guy has ever said something to you that was sexual, mm-hmm. and they're in a position of power, mm-hmm. and you go to them, and honestly, at times, they're making a professional judgment call. Mm-hmm. They'll be like, no, I don't think you can do that.
Or yeah, there's been an issue of...
Then the women will go back and be like, oh, because I refuse to do this, now that's sexual harassment. He's mm-hmm. not giving me what is due me. I'm like, no, it doesn't work like that. And that's why when I was reading this story, because it has ever so many facets, I want to get the context, because she says it reached down to a point where she couldn't afford to pay.
Yeah.
But then I'm asking, where's your HR?
Mm-mm.
That's an entire ministry. A dickhead? Where's your husband?
If we could come back to the workplaces, most of these cases that have been reported to do with sexual harassment are usually from the females, and of course they're the ones complaining about the males.
Oh. It's sad.
Because the males...
Our men... No, I keep telling people...
Is
this
because our men are not sexually harassed?
No. Mm-hmm. We keep shouting that, oh, men are doing this, men are doing that, and we forget. We are raising the girl child so well, but who is raising the male child?
Me, I'll tell you this, that... it is hard for a man to say that they've been sexually harassed. Mm. Why?
It takes away your manhood.
Yes. Number one, you sort of feel less of a man. And two, someone is going to laugh at you and say, I mean...
Why?
You?
Let me tell you.
As in, you couldn't even take advantage of that.
If you came to me, Willis, if you came to me and you said, yo, man, all you chick wear the office, man, I'd be like, let's go get her.
And for
let's
you and Willis are friends. I mean,
no, I would be with you on that committee. We would say,
imagine Willis going to the HR
and say,
I'm saying, I have been sexually harassed by this chick.
Okay, can I go for you?
And do what?
And I'm like, well, he's to the HR. Because it takes away his
Many manhood. People have mistaken bosses for sexual harassment when they talk about women's dressing code. Mm-hmm. So when someone sends you an email and says, Tina, your pants are too tight these days. Eh? Mm. Please work it out.
The situation that was happening at the Ministry of Health.
Yeah, so she says, you know what? This guy is sexually harassing me. I mean, my clothes are mine.
That's I can unfair. Decide yeah, how to wear, how to dress her.
But I think that sometimes we try to, let's say, guilt trap people.
Mm.
Yeah, we try to guilt trap people and take them out of context.
I'm just saying in general,
yes,
yeah,
that there are rules and regulations of certain brands, and if someone says, you know what, the way you're dressing is
it's a little inappropriate. Bit
old. Is it think about we it. Have dress codes like ethical kind of things at workplaces?
Yeah, yeah, and have dress many organizations.
Yeah, we do.
We do have we do.
Yes,
we do. Yes, we do. Many organizations.
But I'm a TV personality.
Mm. But you're not supposed to dress a type of way.
Which type of way?
Mini
your
skirts.
Thighs out. Mini skirts.
If you show your thighs, if your pants are too tight,
no.
Your banana,
you don't get it. I cannot come on TV in a certain outfit.
Exactly.
But wait, coming on TV is different from me being in my workspace.
Yes, in your workspace, you're not supposed to.
Yes.
If your thighs, if your thighs are revealing, you're sexually harassing a man.
I'm going to be
the problem.
I think I'm going to sexually harass that entire new vision.
No, you know,
I think yesterday I sexually harassed everyone.
No, you didn't.
Because I was worried.
I'm going to give you an example. You see how you're going for dinner or you're going for an event and then you wear this nice dress with a very long sleeve up to, say, around here. You can wear that to work.
Why not?
You sexually harassing people.
How?
It's not in the terms of ethics. You'll be someone to the HR.
Well,
simple.
I mean...
If you're arguing, you try it tomorrow.
Yeah, I will.
And then, of course, for me, the interns who... I feel very, very sad for the interns because it's going to be hard for interns to tell between sexual harassment and having mature conversations. And most of the cases...
Why would you be having a mature conversation
with them?
Because they are grown-up people.
They are above in the legal edge gap.
Yes.
But
are they mature enough? Mentally?
Yes.
We
have girls who are 16 and they are mothers. What are you talking about?
These interns don't come here to have a mature conversation.
They come to learn. But that is part of learning.
Yeah.
And that's where we get it wrong.
Sex to them is part of learning?
Yes.
Why are you talking sex with them?
I've entered office.
Why are you talking sex with them?
Why shouldn't I be? I mean, if someone studied the reproductive system in P5 10 years, 15 years ago,
that doesn't make you mature enough.
What stops me from talking about the reproductive system with them in a workplace?
Why are you having that conversation with them?
Because they're mature and they need to learn.
No.
So
they are not here to learn sexual lessons from you.
Listen, I want to make you so uncomfortable today. You're saying you can have the conversation. Yeah, adults. I'm going to sit with you for 2 hours straight and we're just going to talk about your situation.
Which situation? What do you mean, which situation?
Your reproductive health.
No, you're not understanding what I'm saying.
Because you're mature enough.
What I am saying is that people avoid to help these young people understand relationships at work, which is part of the lessons that interns are supposed to learn. How do you handle relationships at work? When your boss tries to get in a relationship with you, how do you handle it? Mm-hmm. You understand? These are things you learn at work. No lecturer is going to teach you these things.
So if I
sit down with an intern and say, look, if you're working in a TV environment, this thing is going to happen. This one is going to try to hit on you. This one is going to try to hit on you in order for you to get on air. If you see a story about me banging Gina in the Kampala Sun, it's not true. I'm not sexually harassing her.
You're giving my walkthrough.
Yes, I'm teaching her.
Where does that leave the HR?
What?
It's the HR supposed to do that.
No.
You as Willis, if they have given you an intern, this is what I believe. You're going to work with, this intern, she's called Christine. Keep it professional. If Christine comes,
you can remember more. Brands and organizations have moved away from the fact that you can't have relationships at work. Why? Because we spend almost 90% of our times with our workmates.
With the same people.
You understand? If you're going to spend probably 5 weeks around this intern and you like her,
Willis, you're about to shoot
your shot. Shoot your shot. What becomes sexual harassment is if she's not welcoming it and you keep going, that becomes sexual harassment.
But so I think in this woman's take, that means the guy shot his shot.
He overshot his shot for 10 years.
So he overshot his shot.
Ten years, didn't you find something to tell this guy?
By the time she gets to campus,
19, 20, adult, according to the law, for me, in the case of Mwesije, I would say that when a man says he wants some and you don't want to give him some, you just have to be honest about it and say, I don't like you. But he may insist because we are men. So you might want to say it a couple of times.
And because women never say yes.
For 10 years? Yes. And you say,
For 10 years, boo, is not a couple of times. 10 years is a lifetime.
Where I become a full life sentence.
Kulemerako for like just 3 weeks now. When is our WhatsApp messages? You first start with the regular stuff. You're like, you know what, guy? I'm not for it. I don't like you like that. We're not doing this. Now, kudamu nkira.
Amen. Olu dago.
too many.
If someone wants some and you don't want some, it can even go for a lifetime. Your job is to just continue saying no. But if someone starts saying, because you said no, you will not get this promotion, that starts to become harassment.
Yeah, that's harassment.
You understand? There, I would say, man, you're harassing someone. You understand? You're
making him feel uncomfortable. A man can ask for a slick way
to put you in your place.
For how many years? Where we could
since
ask.
You've
asked what?
The first younger man, son.
Someone has been asking.
And then there's guys who accidentally, you know, have touchy hands. Not accidentally, but people have
like they're touchy feeling. Like yeah. I talk with my
they want to hug all the time, they want to
I talk
it's
with them
like a disorder as well.
No, it's not a disorder. It's not a disorder, it's someone's nature.
Remember how
there's some people who are.
I have a friend of ours, you both know him, who used to talk like this. Starting with guys, whether it is a woman, whether it is a man, you're like, dude, I'm sitting right here.
And he was my boss sometimes. So when you're talking to Senda, like, you go wear a jacket if you have a white shirt. Otherwise, not just wearing a patch is one. But you know, it just depends on the maturity of it. That men and women, by nature, we are sexually attracted to each other.
It just works that way.
If someone is asking you, if someone is saying they want some, that's okay. Mm-hmm. That's natural. If someone is giving you hugs every morning and whatnot, and you know, you feel uncomfortable about it, you're probably
stop
married.
The hugs.
You say, you know what, don't give me a hug. Try to avoid them, move in different places. And what, just leave together.
You are
together.
A hug, more
handshake. A more handshake. You embarrass him a few times.
That's
and then
weird.
He will stop. But also,
I think
the guys who are being sexually harassed.
Embarrassed does work the most. That's why I'm saying, for 10 years, either you have to be a certain type of, I won't use the word.
Or you have gold.
Men
because
embarrassed
a man hates embarrassment, especially if they're in a position of power.
Yeah.
You can actually use that to your advantage. Mm-hmm. Every time he's like, yeah, you're like.
So Samantha Mosije, if you're watching us or your friend is watching us on your behalf, they can tell you just, you know, embarrass this man and everything will go to
waste. But now she has embarrassed him.
Not yet.
She's a lawyer. She wants, I think she might want.
There is no concrete evidence. You see, for us in court,
there's a leaked conversation between her and the Right Honorable Prime Minister when she was reporting to him and saying, look, I've taken this case up in my bosses and they're not doing anything, so I come to you as Prime Minister.
And what has the Prime Minister said?
Well, we haven't.
We shall deal with it. You know,
I mean, we also had leaked WhatsApp messages from Hassan Kasinje with a number that had never been on WhatsApp. So clearly, anything is possible.
Don't insinuate.
You see, in court, if they say this is a cap, I mean, say this is not a cap. Give me evidence why you think this is a cap.
I like how women organizations and NGOs jumped
on it
and just defend things without conclusion.
Exactly.
As long as someone reports, they just go on Twitter. And you know, tarnish.
And actually,
they
watch the show a lot, the morning show, and they're like, "Yo, Tina, you're just not team the women." I'm like, "What do you mean team the women? I am team logic."
Mbuli Garcia governor ali tanga.
But what's so with them? Mbuli kasasiro enagwe mulane tanga because I'm a woman. I should hold the fort. I should be like, "Yeah, women power." No, you're not going to bring nonsense my way and expect me to jump on it like every feminist.
Oh well, let us use this opportunity to abuse their nonsense. Okay.
But speak out.
Always speak out.
Even if you feel that for you, as long as you feel the sexual harassment,
speak out.
Yeah. Doesn't matter if you're a man or a woman. I've experienced also sexual harassment at work sometime. I think
really?
I was younger. Yeah.
When you just started working.
Yeah. I never spoke out, but I kind of did it differently.
For me, it's different. I'm a chick working in a guy's world. You get what I'm saying? So
sexual harassment
at work is like your cup of tea.
So have you gone through that, you know, kind of situation?
I know how to deal. Because I know it's a man's...
But you have gone through...
It's a man's world out here.
Although for a guy, when you sexually harass a guy, they kind of...
Can I stop harassing me? Moving on, of course, we want to get into some strange but true facts. That was the first one. So if you didn't know, now you know. But anyway, this one is very interesting. Once upon a time, Charlie Chaplin entered a contest four Charlie Chaplin look-alikes, and he came in third.
I read that. I'm a Charlie Chaplin fan.
You're very own look-alike, but you still come out third. That means there's a guy who looks alike than more than you.
Who did it better? But there's a fact I love about Charlie Chaplin that actually scares me. Charlie Chaplin got so much money, and he died very poor. But here's the twist. His mom and manager had all his money. And he never even knew it. He died a very poor man, and he's still making money off it up to today.
But imagine they say, we are going to say, Tina look-alike. Then you go to compete for the look-alike of Tina.
And some Kasasilo takes it.
Someone looks like Tina like
me
more than you look.
Someone
like
looks alike me more.
And even the judges can't tell that you're the actual Tina.
But I can fire the judges, the organizers of the event, makeup artist Wangi.
Strange but true, number two or number three. You are not stuck in traffic. You are traffic itself. Yeah, so let us avoid this tendency of I'm stuck in traffic. Just say I am traffic.
I'm traffic.
Oh, you are. I'm traffic, man.
I'm traffic.
Yeah. I'm traffic.
Say it's like what do you mean you're stuck?
I'm not
in traffic?
Stuck in traffic. I am the traffic.
You're traffic. You are part of the people that are stuck causing the traffic. So you're clearly traffic.
Wow.
Yeah. Things that happen. I'm going
to go to Katageda, by the way. Faruko Katageda.
That's really Faruko Katageda. Faruk, are you traffic or you're stuck in traffic? Let us go in for a quick break, but when we do get back, of course, it's going to be sports this morning, and Nicholas will be here to give us an update of what is happening in the world of sports. So keep it right here with us on Urban Television.